Sumit Injay Vinsode from JSPM and PSSM Group of Institute, Nare, Pune. So today we are going to see the practical of transportation engineering. That practical is belonging to the shape of the aggregate. We have to determine the flatness and elongation index of the aggregate. So what happens when using this aggregate in the road pavement? The aggregate, it may be elongated or maybe some flattened, means thick, or just have some dimension which is a 3/5 of the larger size, that should be the lesser than that of, then that side of the aggregate that is not suitable for the road pavement. If elongated aggregates are there, then this aggregate, they may be break down into two different parts or maybe three different parts depending on their nature of the breaking. So due to this, there may be also chances of failure of the pavement. We have to find the actual elongated aggregate and the flaky aggregate. If flaky aggregates are there, that may be also going to break down, and elongated aggregates, that may be also going to break down. Now here, what we require, the apparatus are the length gauge or the and the thickness gauge. So we need the weigh balance and sieve sets as per IS standards. And this practical to be conducted depending on the IS code 2386 part 1. So first we will calculate what is the flatness index. So flatness index is depending on the thickness of the aggregate. So the least dimension of that aggregate, that will be nothing but the thickness. So if this least dimension is 3/5 of the larger size, then that kind of the aggregate are going to be called as the flaky aggregate. So we have to find out whether these aggregates are present in our aggregate or not. If these aggregates are there, that may cause some failure in our road pavement. That aggregate, it may going to be break down. This is the thickness gauge, or we can call it as a flatness gauge. So here we can find different sieve sizes. It has been written over here: 60 to 50, 50 to 40, 40 to 31.5, 31.5 to 25, then 25 to 20, 20 to 16, 16 to 12.5, 12.5 to 10, and last 10 to 6.3. It means that below 6.3, this gauge is not suitable for the aggregate. So all dimension, these are present in the EMM. What we have to do, we have to take the aggregate in our hand and we are just pass through this. So this aggregate is belonging to the 63 mm. To 50 mm, it has been written over the 50 mm size. So we have to just check what is the thickness of this. So this aggregate is passing through the gauge, so we can call as this aggregate is passing through the gauge. So take the another aggregate, so we have to try it in each and every dimension. So this aggregate is not passing, it means that this aggregate is written over the sieve. So we have to keep it aside, so we have to take another one. We have to again check what is the thickness of this aggregate. So it is not passing at any dimension of this aggregate, so we will call it as the retained aggregate. So I have these two aggregates with me. This aggregate is passing through the thickness gauge and this aggregate is not passing through the thickness gauge. So I have to note down the weight of passing and also the weight of retained of the aggregate, and this should be mentioned in the observation table. So the total weight of aggregate will be this much of the aggregate, and this is the retained weight, so passing weight, and this is the retained weight of the aggregate. Simultaneously, we have to find all the aggregates which are passing through each and every sieve or not, and that aggregate, it should be treated as a passing aggregate and retained aggregate as per the criteria. So we have to check all these aggregates, whether they are passing through or whether they are retaining on the sieve, and just we have to calculate the weight of actual passing and weight of actual retained through the flatness gauge. This is the procedure for finding out the flatness index of the aggregate. Now we have to find out, we have to take nearly about minimum 200 numbers of aggregates of each and every sieve, and that should be taken consideration depending for the finding out the average of all the aggregates. So now we will move towards the actual process we have done. We will move towards the calculations.
After weighing the material which is passing and written on the gauge, we have to just enter the all value in the observation table. So 63 and 50 mm means 10 on 50 mm. Total weight of aggregate is 200 grams. Out of that 240 grams is the weight of aggregate which is passing through the correctness gauge. Means total weight of aggregate is 240 grams. Now second is from 50 to 40 aggregate weight is 210 grams. Out of that 10 grams is passing through the gauge and 200 grams is retained on the seal. Likewise, we have just found out all the weight of aggregate which is retained on the gauge and weight of aggregate that is passing through the gauge. So total weight of aggregate which is passing through the gauge is 52 grams and weight of aggregate retained on this is the 770 grams. Moving towards the calculation. So for determination of thickness index, weight of aggregate passing through the thickness gauge divided by weight of total weight of the aggregate into 100. So weight of aggregate passing through thickness gauge is 52 and total weight of aggregate is 822 into 100. So it will give us the value of 6.32%. Means the thickness index of the aggregate given for the sample are 6.32%. Now if you apply it for the site, so what is necessary as per the IRC, Indian Rule of Thumb, has been stated that flatness index should not be greater than 15% for BM and WBM roads, and it should not be more than 25% for bituminous concrete and bituminous concrete surface dressings. So this is the application of flatness index for the road pavement, road constructions. Okay, second part of this experiment is to determine the elongation index. For elongation index, what we have to do, we have to take the length gauge. So if you observe the length gauge clearly, here it has been shown that this is for the 63 mm and 50 mm, 50 to 40, 40 to 31.5, 31.5 to 25, then 25 to 20, 20 to 16. Then 16 to 12.5, 12.5 to 10, 10 to 6.3. So this is the last aggregate. So we can say that below 6.3 size of the aggregate, this test should not be used. So this is the limitation of this test. Now what we have to do? We have to again do the same thing as we have did in the flatness gauge, but here we have to find out the maximum dimension of the aggregate. So what we will take this aggregate. This is of the 63 mm and 50 mm. So the maximum dimension of this aggregate that should be checked properly, means each and every dimension, each and every direction. So if this aggregate is not moving with the length wise, so we can call that this aggregate is retaining on the ISU. Now if you take the another aggregate, this aggregate is also not passing through the gauge. So this is also retained aggregate from the gauge. But if you observe this third aggregate, it is passing through the gauge, so we can call it as this aggregate is passing. So again we will say this aggregate is passing through the length gauge, and this aggregate they are retained on the length gauge. Likewise, we have to do for same thing. So this aggregate is passing through the 50 to 40 window. Okay, this aggregate is retaining. So I am keep aside this aggregate. So this aggregate is not also passing. So should be kept aside. This aggregate is not passing. It means that these are the retaining aggregate. So these are the passing aggregate. Just put these are the also passing aggregate. This is the passing aggregate. So we can say that these aggregate are passing and these aggregate that are going to retain on the seals. Likewise, we have to check all aggregates through the length gauge. So but we have to take care about the maximum dimension that should be taken into consideration while passing all the aggregates through the length gauge. So now we will move towards the observation table. As per the elongation index, the passing aggregate and the retained aggregate, it has been written over here. So 63 passing, 50 retained, the total aggregate is of 143 plus 52. Among that 143 gram aggregate they have retained on the gauge,
and 52 gram of aggregate they have passing through the bridge. Likewise, we have just calculated all the values. We have just weighed all the values from the weigh balance, and we got this result. Some of the aggregate retained on the length gauge is about 918, and the aggregate which are passing through the length gauge is 349 grams. Now, moving towards the calculation, so for determination of the elongation index, the weight of aggregate which passed through the length gauge divided by total weight of aggregate into 100, this is the formula. So 349 divided by 1267 grams of aggregate into 100. So we are getting a result of 27.54%. Now if we move along the application, so application of this test is that as per IRC, IRC says that below 15% elongation index that will be acceptable for the road construction. But if quarry site is not available nearby, then more than 25% are not acceptable, but below 15% that will be acceptable as quarry site is not available within the stretch. So it means that the cost of construction, it may be increased due to the maximum transportation charges. So we can avoid that cost of construction. So we can use the aggregate which shows the below 25% result. But in this condition, what we are having, we are getting result as 27.54%. So these aggregates that are not suitable for the construction of road pavement. So from this elongation and thickness index, we can say that the aggregate which are best suited is for thickness index below 15%, thickness index, that aggregate that can be used for the road construction, and also the for elongation index below 15%, that aggregate are also acceptable for the road construction. But if we are getting the result more than this, then the 25% is the limit, that limit giving us that whether that aggregate that should be used or not for the road construction. Otherwise, we have to just import the aggregate from around periphery. So here we have completed the experiment of the flatness and elongation index. Thank you.